My Mum Story by Pippa Best. My mothering journey in 10 photos that I love for storyofmum.com. Pregnancy changed my relationship with my body. I still struggle to love my wobbly bits, but pregnancy gave me a new respect for the miraculous thing that a mummy's body is. It gave me a sense of purpose instead of frustration. I felt that I was powerful and creative, and there was a point for this flabby belly that had otherwise irritated me up until then. The birth of my son was hard work and amazing, but it left me very confused about who I was, no longer defined by my work and struggling to breastfeed, trying to be the mum I thought I would or should be, and worried that my choices were risking my son's health as I was constantly harassed by health visitors. He turned out okay. My dad, obviously a dad was born too. I saw my husband's playfulness, strength and softness. I loved him more for that. But focusing all my love on my children left little space for us. I started calling him Dad. And the idea stuck in my head. We became more parents than partners, and sleep seemed so much more important than time together. Our daughter was born nearly 3 years later. And with both of my children, I experienced moments of bliss in a way that I don't think I've felt elsewhere in my life. Fleeting, but wonderful. Quietly feeding or holding my child as they drifted off to sleep in my arms, on a soft bed made with fresh sheets in a sun-filled room. There's nothing better in life. However, the rest of the time was a sugar and caffeine-fueled, sweaty ball pool of commitments to family, to work, to trying to set up a story of mum, trying to be everything to everyone, but not making time for myself or my relationship, and always questioning whether I'd got it right, whether I was any good at any of the things I was trying to do. I took the kids to Singapore for my brother's wedding when my daughter was just 3 months old and my son was three. My husband couldn't come, but my ever-supportive parents and brother were there and they helped. It was really difficult and brilliant, and it was a really important proof for me that I could achieve things that I thought were impossible. The kids could come along for the ride. I cried when both my children started childcare, and they started early, for a few hours a week from 7 months old. I'm lucky, I have wonderful people looking after them and they absolutely love being there. I need to work for money and for me. But I still feel that guilt and question my choices almost every day. An empty pushchair is not something I like to look at. So as the kids grow up, they're in turns heart-milkingly cute and exhaustingly argumentative. Their relationship reminds me of my own childhood and my relationship with my brothers. And my heart swells in the moments when they're kind to each other. I'm learning how to be a better mum to them every day. My son's just started school, which was another big wrench for me. And I love how my children help me to look at the world differently, to see the joy in the everyday, to look up from the toilet of life to the wonder of the flush mechanism. This is a picture my son took with his first camera, and I was going, what are you taking a picture of that for? And then I realised, actually, a flush mechanism is a pretty impressive piece of equipment. At the end of last year, my husband and I went away to a wedding for a weekend without the kids. It rained, we missed them, we talked about them a lot, but we reconnected. And we remembered that at the heart of this family is a couple. We need to work at that. I'm a mum, I'm a wife, I'm a woman, and I am doing my best, which is all that any of us can try to do.